Hello friends, welcome back again. Some of you have requested me to make a video on strain gauge transducer. So in this video I will be talking about that. So just subscribe the channel and click the bell icon to get regular updates. Thank you. So welcome back again, and today I'm going to discuss about strain gauge. So let us give a heading here. So it's about strain gauge. You can say it strain gauge also, no problem. The first thing that you need to know about strain gauge, that it is a metal conductor. Okay, so it is just a metal conductor. The second thing is it can be stretched or compressed, so it is basically subjected of stretching or compression. So you have to provide two type of operation, and that will be a mechanical load operation. Okay, it's a mechanical load operation. Mechanical load because of you can give a stretching effect or compression effect. Now coming to back, how can it work? The first thing you need to know about that there is a change in the value of resistivity if the conductor when it's strained, and this property called piezoresistive effect. Okay, so if you give some kind of thrust here, it will change the conductivity. So it has some kind of conductivity here, and if you give some kind of thrust, that conductivity will vary because of thrust, and that effect is called as piezoresistive effect. Next, coming to that point, that is also called as piezoresistive gauge. Now how does a strain gauge work? So the change of the value of resistance of straining gauge may be partly explained by the normal dimension behavior. It's just like an elastic material operation. Okay, so it is just like an elastic operation. Let us consider a zone here. That is a zone, or that's the length we are going to consider about strain gauge. Let us consider that length is L and the diameter is capital D, and we are giving some kind of force here. Okay, and that force, it is a stretching force, it is F, and we are applying this stretching force with the two end. Now because of that, there will be some change in diameter and there will be some change in length. So just imagine, because of that stretching operation, the change in length, there is some kind of change in length and there is some kind of change in diameter. Okay, because of that. So because of that change in diameter, the change is delta D, and because of change in length, the length is delta L. So now what will happen? The first thing, that the resistance of the unstrained gauge, what was the resistance of the unstrained gauge? It is the L length, is the length, it is the diameter here. And if I just think that the resistivity is rho, okay, is rho, then resistance of unstrained gauge, what will be the resistance of the unstrained gauge? R is equals to rho L by A. Now let us tensile strength is applied here, and because of that there is some kind of changes, that the changes we are considering here. So what will happen if the tensile strength is L? Okay, so if the tensile here it is F, so what will happen? Dr by ds is equals to rho by A del L by del S. We are considering that is F as F, so it is F here, minus rho L by A square rho A by del F plus L by A del rho by del F. That will be the expression. And if I just divide both side through R is equals to rho L by A, if I divide both side here, what I can get? 1 by R del R by del F is equals to 1 by L del L by del F minus 1 by A, del A by del F plus 1 by rho, del rho by del F. So from that there will be some kind of evident we can get, what, that the per unit change is del L by L, per unit change in area is del A by A, and per unit change in resistivity is del rho by rho. So per unit change in length del L by L, area del A by A, resistivity del rho by rho. Now putting area as area is equals to pi d square by 4 because the diameter was d, and putting here what can we get, del A by del F is equals to 2 pi, if I am just differentiating it, okay, so 2 into pi by 4 del multiplied by d multiplied by del d by del f, or 1 by a del a by del f is equals to 2 pi by 4 d multiplied by del d divided by pi by 4 d square multiplied by del f is equals to 2 by d del d by del f. That is the value we can get. I am just considering here that a is equals to pi d square by 4. I just differentiated that, and after that I put the value of 1 by a here, because I just put the value here and got that expression. So that equation, okay, that equation can be written like that. Why, what will be the expression now? 1 by r del r by del f is equals to 1 by l del l by del f minus 2 by d del d by del f plus 1 by rho del p by del s, sorry, del f. Now Poisson ratio, you know what is the Poisson ratio, that is 1 by the Poisson ratio del d by d by del l by l minus, of course is a minus, again that value putting here 1 by r del r by del s is equals to 1 by l del l by del s plus b into 2 by l del l by del s plus 1 by rho plus 1 by rho del rho by del s. Here I am just considering s as f, so I am just making that expression by day by day, time by time, and I am making that mistake because I thought that it will be a strength of tensile stress, so I just considered as s, but it will be, I just considered as force tensile strength as f, so expressions will be like that. Now from that we can implement the value of gauge factor. What will be the value of gauge factor? That will be delta r by r divided by delta l by l, or delta r by r can be written as gauge factor multiplied by delta l by l is equals to gauge factor multiplied by epsilon. That is the strain, okay, epsilon is the value of strain here, del l by l. So these are the some expression of the calculation expression of strain gauge. Now coming to back, what is the need of strain gauge here? See, first thing, that why should I need the strain gauge? I'm just keeping this expression. I may consider that you have taken down it. Now coming to back to the point, that why we need strain gauge. First thing, that strain gauge can be applied to calculate load. Load means weight. Okay. The second thing that can strain gauge can calculate, it is the amount of thrust. And again, I said load, weight, thrust, this kind of object, this kind of parameters, not objects, parameters can be calculated by strain gauge. The strain gauge has very different type of diagrams, different type of specifications. Here I am going to consider talk about bonded metal foil strain gauge. It is the circuit, it is a basic diagram of a bonded metal coil phase ball strain gauge. Here it will be a foil. Okay, so if you just look in this kind of strain gauge, you will see that there is a kind of strip draw over that gauge, and it has a base also. That part is called as base, and the foil is been mounted like that. And these two connections are basically soldered. Okay, what is happening in this kind of thing, that if you give some kind of strain here, that gauge will get some kind of difference in resistance, and their supply voltage will be differ. There are some gauge resistance here. Okay, the gauge resistance of typical bonded type is 120 to 350 and 1000. This kind of resistance value it has, 120 ohm, 350 ohm and 1000 ohm. Let me write it clearly, 120 ohm, 350 ohm and 1000 ohm. So if you give the thrust here, the resistance will differ, and from that difference of the resistance we can calculate the amount of strain which is been applied here. So that is the basic of a strain gauge. Okay, I think there are so many strain gauges, and if I try to elaborate everything, it will take a long hour time. So basically that was the expression, that was the calculation about the strain here. You can thoroughly read it and you can just focus on that circuit, because that is the basic, you can easily understand. Just apply strain here and there will be some kind of change in the resistance, and from that we can calculate the value. So I hope you have enjoyed this. Thank you.